The rivers, which started from the mountains and have been flowing through the foothills, the alluvial plains, and the floodplains, have eventually reached the sea. The sediments they carry and which they will deposit in the marine environment have been mainly produced in the mountainous regions, have been substantially modified in amount and type during the course. The amount of sediments which reaches the sea depends on the amount of sediment produced in the source area and how much of this has been deposited in subsiding domains prior to reaching the sea. You can see that by far the largest amount of sediments is transported by the rivers draining the Himalayas. These mountains experience strong uplift, are affected by very strong precipitations, and are relatively close to the sea, decreasing the amount of sediment abandoned in the continent. Sediments are eventually brought to the sea. The type of sedimentary structure the rivers and the sediments they carry will form depends on what the river brings and, on the other side, on the processes taking place in the coastal domain. We will look in more detail into these processes during the next clip, but for the moment, it is enough to consider in a qualitative sense waves, currents, and tides. I'm sure all of you have at least a qualitative knowledge of these phenomena. We distinguish two end members, estuaries and deltas. Estuaries are semi-enclosed coastal bodies of water with free connection with the open sea and where seawater is measurably diluted with fresh water derived from land drainage. They typically form during the other glaciations when lower sea level activated erosion and the formation of valleys deeper than present sea level. Deltas are a landform which develops from the deposition of sediments carried by the river as the flow leaves its mouth and ends up slow-moving or standing water, typically the sea. Estuaries and deltas are an end member of a continuum. In general, deltas are favored by high sediment input and weak movements in the water column, which prevents sediments being transported away. Deltas play a major role in present-day coastal domain as well as in the geologic record. Because they are associated with large sediment input, deltas grow in size. As the incoming sediment cannot be stored above sea level, it will be transported and dumped in front of the delta slope. In a vertical section, you can see the results of such a delta growth. At each stage, coarse grain sediments are dropped at the delta top, sands are deposited in layers dipping towards the sea, and silts and shale being deposited at the toe of the forceps. And now, we really need to look at what is happening in the sea.